This is the BBC third program. Music from Canterbury. This evening we are broadcasting a concert given in the chapter house of Canterbury Cathedral by permission of the Dean and Chapter. Taking part are the Deller Consort, two sopranos, Eileen Poulter and Mary Thomas, two counter-tenors, Alfred Deller and John Whitworth, two tenors, Wilfred Brown and Gerald English, and two baritones, Maurice, Bevan and Owen Grundy. The Canterbury Cathedral Choir, with the master of the choristers, Sidney Campbell, who plays the chamber organ, Charles Spinks, harpsichord continuo, and the Calmar Chamber Orchestra, led by Carl Peeney. The concert is directed by Alfred Deller. This year, we are celebrating the 250th anniversary of the births of Arne and Boyce. The second part of this concert is devoted to a revival of a masque by Arne, the Fairy Prince. And we begin with music by Boyce, the fifth of his eight symphonies. This is in the key of D and is scored for two oboes, two trumpets, and strings. There are three movements, the second of which is a gavotte, and the last a minuet.
Thank you.
Now follow two anthems by John Blow. The first, Salvator Mundi. The second, the more extended, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude.
Thank you. Blood of the Lamb, in the blood.
First part of the concert ends with the Te Deum in D by Purcell. Unlike most of Purcell's church music, it was not originally intended for liturgical use. It was written for the St. Cecilia's Day celebrations of 1694 in place of the customary ode. Later, however, it was revived for great religious and ceremonial occasions and was used for the Thanksgiving service at St. Paul's Cathedral after the Battle of Oudenarde in 1708. The character of the setting is both bold and brilliant and uses a large group of solo voices in addition to the chorus, as well as an orchestra in which the strings are reinforced by a pair of trumpets who have parts of unusual virtuosity for the period. The Te Deum in D. Purcell's Te Deum in D ends the first part of tonight's concert of music from Canterbury.